thanks for coming in, Greg.
Thank you, Ed.
Well, it's no secret we're interested. You know, Prudential has narrowed our search for a new CFO down to just you and one other candidate.
Well, I know you guys met with Steve Kimball. He's a good guy.
Oh, yeah, he's fantastic.
Yeah.
Okay. So, let's just talk. Tell me about your work experience.
As you know, most recently, I was the COO at Amazon and head of marketing before that.
Uh-huh. And before that, it was Microsoft.
Yeah, I was at Microsoft for 7 years.
What was it like working with Bill Gates?
I was never actually introduced to Bill,
but
I did get to use his private bathroom.
Uh-huh.
Pretty nice!
Oh, I can imagine!
No, you can't!
Okay, and before Microsoft, it was...
Starcom.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I worked there right when we took it public.
Sure.
And I was an intern at J.P. Morgan before that.
All right, before that?
I was at Princeton. And I worked at the Cheddar Bay Lobster House.
And what did you do there?
I was a waiter.
And what were your responsibilities?
Well, I had to bring food and beverage to people's tables.
Sure.
Have a pretty good general knowledge of the menu.
Uh-huh. I tell you what, Greg, what do you think your experience, how do you think that'll help you as a CFO at Prudential?
Good, yes. When I was chief of operations at Amazon, we had
Greg, at the Cheddar Bay Lobster House.
Well, I suppose I had to learn how to multitask.
Sure.
Always look presentable.
Yeah.
Have a clean apron.
See that.
The right number of click pens.
Oh, right. So, Greg, what did you do before you were a waiter at the Cheddar Bay Lobster?
I was a busser there.
Okay, and what were your duties as a busser?
Well, there was just two bussers.
Sure.
Me and this guy named Randall.
Okay, did you just get the bread and water, or?
No, we reset all the tables.
Uh-huh.
Took the trash out.
Now, how do you think this experience will help you as a CFO?
Honestly, Ed, I don't think it will. But I do think my executive experience at Amazon and Microsoft will help me be a leader here at Prudential.
You know, Steve Kimball, he said that his valet parking experience taught him how to hustle, how to manage cash flow, and how to speak street Spanish.
I picked up a little Spanish from the line cooks. Chinga tu madre.
What does that mean?
Fuck your mother.
I spoke to Todd, the manager at the Cheddar Bay Lobster House.
Todd? He still works there?
Oh no, he's moved on, but we tracked him down. He remembered you. He thought you were a good overall employee, but you were a little weak in pushing the specials.
Everybody just wanted the Cheddar Bay Chowder.
Now, I also had a nice conversation with Randall, the other busboy. He liked you, but he thought there were some nights when he was kind of pulling more of the weight.
Randall? With the weird numbers tattooed on his neck?
That's called a barcode.
Okay, look, Ed, I don't know why you're so fixated on my job at the Lobster House. That was a part-time job I did to help pay for business school.
Well, now, Greg...
No, Ed, this is my fourth interview, okay? I deserve to be here. All right? I was nominated for Executive of the Year 2 years ago. And I took a small startup public and got a huge offering, and I know if you made me CFO, I could bring this company to the next level.
Well, Todd and Randall both said you had a lot of confidence. I can see that now. Now under desired salary, you put $300,000 to $400,000 annually.
That's about what I was making at Amazon.
Uh-huh. And
What were you making at the Cheddar Bakery?